that, sir. I'm not here to comfort this. So be encouraged. Lord, how I think increased that trouble me. Many are they that rise up against me. Many there be which say of my soul.
Thank you for lifting my head. Hallelujah. I welcome you to the presence of the Most High. Thanks so much for tuning in to PRZFM 109.2. My name is Remy Kende Tawo. I'm broadcasting live from PRZ London studio, and I'm the host of the Prayer Rally Special Conference, Prayer Conference, the Prayer of the Psalmist, the Prayer of the Psalmist. So I welcome all the listeners who have just tuned in all over the world to the presence of God, to your place of altar, to this very altar, the altar of praise, in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you, all the sons and the daughters of Issachar, those who know what Israel ought to do, who understand what Israel ought to do, and who are blessed in their tent. I welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you, all the great men and women of great understanding, who knows how to adjust their sail and boat in the storm of deep waters. I welcome you to the presence of God. I say it's going to be awesome tonight, or this hour, in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome people of great understanding who, when you throw them to the wolves, they will lead the pack. I welcome you to the presence of God. I welcome all the Zebulun. I'm talking about the Zebulunites and the Zebulunites. If I were to coin it, who have been blessed and who will dwell by the haven of the sea. as blessed by Jacob in the book of Genesis 49. I welcome you all because you will be blessed in your going in and your coming out in the mighty name of Jesus. I call out to warriors who will not run back, who will not turn back, who will not be driven back by the storm of life. I welcome you to the presence of God. I say I welcome all the warriors, the valiant men and women, people who are determined, the sons and daughters of Zion, who will not run back in the days of battle like the sons of Ephraim. The Bible said they ran back. They were men armed with bow, but they turned back in the days of battle. I welcome you in the presence of God. You are welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome those, Jacob, who will not allow their weapon of warfare, which is prayer, to drop off in their hand. Oh, they will not allow the destroyer to ruin or destroy their weapon. I welcome you to the mighty, to the presence of God. Those who will rise up and say the mighty will not fall in the mighty name of Jesus. The weapon of warfare will not perish in our hand. I say thou art welcome to the presence of God. It's going to be awesome in the mighty name of Jesus as we trash through the tent of the psalmist. We have been going through we have touched over 119 psalms without wavering, without shifting, without we have trashed through, and we're still standing by his grace in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you to the presence of God. It's going to be awesome in the mighty name of Jesus because we continue to scale over us. Let me say, you will scale over us. We will rush, we will charge, we will charge through the tent of the psalmist. Then we have about 30 remaining in the mighty name of Jesus, and we're going to do the next 7 tonight together in the mighty name of Jesus. I am very delighted. I say, I call out to, and whooping with excitement, I feel honored to stand alongside with every warrior, every daughter and son of Zion, every redeemer of the Lord. I am excited to stand alongside with you tonight before the Lord, believing that we will return, I'd say, to the, with joy like the days of apostles. When they were appointed on the mission, the Bible said they returned with joy. That was what the Bible quoted in the book of Luke chapter 10 verse 17. And they said, even demons, they are submitting to us in your name. They returned with joy. So we will return to this hour in the mighty name of Jesus. As you have returned tonight, at this moment before the throne of grace, the Lord will honor you. Thanks so much for tuning in and for returning back to the place of prayer, to the place of altar. The Lord will honor you in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. To this hour, this moment, I welcome you to the tent of the psalmist, the prayer of the psalmist. We have been trashing through the tent of the psalmist. And today, let me say today, this very volume, this very series is the fifth volume. Let me say the fifth volume, the last book of the Psalms, fifth volume, which covers from 107 right through to 150, the fifth volume. But to this hour, this episode is series 4. Let me tell somebody, this is series 4. Series 4 will cover Psalm 120. Let me say Psalm 120 to 127. It's going to be awesome as you position yourself before the throne, as you position yourself fully charged before the Lord tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, if you can, turn your Bible with me, but before you turn it, please declare it open wherever you are in the mighty name of Jesus, that which you will say tonight, begin to say it, come out with fire, with precision, with power in the mighty name of Jesus. What you will decree tonight, let it land before the throne of grace in the mighty name of Jesus. What you are going to say tonight, I speak to someone and I speak, let it be upon the throne of remembrance in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be a memorial before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. That which you will say tonight will not fall to the ground. It will stand and will be established in the mighty name of Jesus. That which you will speak tonight will not come back void in the mighty name of Jesus. That which I will speak tonight will go forth like two-edged sword. We wave. We go like thunder. We thunder through the heavens tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you to the presence of God, and I declare this meeting open in every home, in every tent, everywhere, any place, and everyone under the sound of my voice. I said, heaven, let heaven open over you in Jesus' mighty name. And I ran and about me in Jesus' name. I release the fire of God upon everyone in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask this fire of God to surround everyone and the blood of Jesus to guide everyone around in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. I sprinkle the blood in the air right now. I clear my airspace, Jekime, that you will hear me clearly. You will hear the deep things of the Spirit. It will come clearly, Jekime, because tonight, this hour, this series, the deep will call unto the deep. As I call unto the deep things, and I call unto warriors, and I call unto sons and daughters of Zion, people will continue to show up in the place of prayer. The Lord will honor you. Amen. And we declare this meeting open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. And we all say amen. Please turn your Bible to the book of Psalm the Psalm 120, epic, say 122, 127. That's what we're going to, the epic, I'll call it the poetic writing, is the book of Psalm 122, 127 we are going to cover tonight. But the beginning of 120 to 137, I'll just put a brief exposition before we go into it. That from 120 to right up to 135, the 15 Psalms, those 15 Psalms, the songs of decrees, the songs of ascent, they are different. They are 15 altogether. So help me tap somebody that this one is special. This one is different. You need to position yourself. Sometimes they call them the gradual Psalms. They call them the songs of the steps because those 15 Psalms are special Psalms. They are songs of decree. It's compulsory. There's a decree over it that it must be. The people must recite this in Israel. They normally they use these 15 Psalms during the three times that all the men in Israel need to present themselves before the Lord whenever they are going to the presence of God. Or sometimes when the songs of Asaph or the musicians are coming down into to the temple, they call them the songs of steps. Those are the meditation. Those are the things that you read. You meditate on your way to see the Lord. Whosoever is going to run through this tent with me must be very ready, must be prepared to go into the holies of holies. They are special. I tell somebody, these Psalms, the tent that you are about to step in, they are called the tent of the ascent, the songs of the decrees. They are special. They are for holy works. They are for what I will call the prayer walk with the Lord. They are for when you are preparing yourself to present yourself before them. These ones are very different for you to meditate. They are very, very different. Four of them out of those 15, I've said out of those 15, four were written by David. They were written by David. Psalm 122, let me say 122, 124, 131, and 133. Out of the 15 Psalms that covers from 120 right up to 134, through four of that, they are written by David, and one by Solomon, which is Psalm 127. So altogether, Solomon has two Psalms, Psalm 72, which we have covered, the tent of Solomon, and another tent of Solomon tonight, and in 127. So tonight, you are going to write through the unknown Yekima, the tent of the psalmist. You will write through the steps of the songs of the decrees, the songs of the ascent, the special song, the meditational song. You will run through it and also run through the tent of Solomon and the Psalm tonight in the mighty name of. So we are going to move from tent to tent. Let me tell somebody, we will move from tent to tent in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, the Lord will honor you. Please let me turn your Bible as we start this before the throne of grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Please let me turn your Bible to Psalm 120. The Psalm 120. When you are there, please, as you turn that Bible, as you touch it, let the fire of God come upon it in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it become powerful in your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. As you draw the words, as you underline, as you pull them, let them become sword in your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray tonight as you lift your sword, you will lift up in victory in the mighty name of Jesus. The lifter of head will lift your head up, Yekima. Everyone under the sand, will you be lifted up in the mighty name of Jesus. Your spirit, your soul will be lifted up in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus. Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Please help me turn to 120, Psalm 120, the very first one of the songs of decree. So I welcome you to the tent of a special song that whosoever wants to see the Lord, whosoever is prepared and ready to meet with the Lord, we step into this tent. We say, step into it. Step in, Yekimi, and see the Lord. Step in and see the Lord. Psalm 120. And the theme is a plea for relief from bitter, a relief from bitter foes, from bitter enemies. That is this what this psalm is all about. So position yourself. Somebody wants to be relieved from bitter enemy, you will position yourself. This is the very first one, the very first one of the songs of the decree, the songs of ascent. I say to someone, seven verses all together, please step in with me. Come into the tent of the psalmist as we run through these scriptures, as we stretch through in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 1 says, in my distress, let me say, in my distress. 120, Psalm 120, verse 1 says, I cried to the Lord, he heard me. Somebody please help me walk up and down and begin to decree in my troubles, in my whatever you are going through. I will cry unto the Lord. He will hear me. Yeah, I cried unto the Lord. He said he heard me. Past tense. Somebody under the sound of my voice. Who is ready? Who is confident? Who can say? Who is sure of the God that they serve? We walk up and down. I say, this God will hear me. He has heard me before. He will hear me again. Begin to declare. As you step into this tent, you say, I cry in my distress. In my distress, I speak to the Lord. In my troubles, I cry to the Lord, and he heard me. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Yeah, we pray. Amen. He said, the Lord will deliver my soul from the lying lips and from deceitful tongue. Begin to pray. Help me step in as you walk through, as we walk down. He said, you will deliver my soul, the inner one. You will deliver it from every, they begin to say, from every lying spirit. Someone help me begin to say and look around and say, hear ye the word of God. Every lying spirit, every deceitful spirit around about me, in my life, ye came up. Tonight, the Lord will deliver my soul. Begin to say it. The Lord must deliver your soul in the mighty name of Jesus. No lying spirit, let no light be found in you. He said, it will not be found in you. Begin to say it in the mighty name. So I decree before the throne of grace, I decree before the saints, I decree before you, the sons and daughters of life, that every lying spirit, begin to say, deceitful spirit, will not be found in me in the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, begin to decree so in Jesus' mighty name. For the Bible says, Jesus said in the book of John, help me say John chapter 14 verse 30, he said the prince of this world came, that was what Jesus, and he found nothing in me. They will not find anything in me. Begin to no lying spirit will be found in me in the mighty name of Jesus. No deceitful spirit will be found in my household. Begin to pray. The lying spirit will not crawl into your household. It will not crawl into that marriage. It will not crawl into the life of your children. Begin to pray. It will not crawl into that business. It will not crawl into your ministry. Every area of your life, it will not crawl into your soul in the mighty name of Jesus. As you pray, so be it in Jesus' mighty name. Please help me draw it. It is sword. Help me draw it and underline it. Draw it, it will become sword, and wave it before the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord will honor you. Help me look at verse 3 in Jesus' mighty name. What shall be given to you, or what shall be done to you? You first tongue. Begin is a question. You will throw it in the fire of the Spirit. You will throw it in the fire of worship. What every first tongue begin to say it. Every lying tongue begin to say it. Every false accusation begin to say it. You will be, what shall I do to you? I will throw you. You decide. You will determine where you put your enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. You will choose where you will send that lying tongue to. First full tongue. Begin to say it. Begin to pray that every lying tongue, I pray before the throne of grace tonight, that I will fling it into the fire, in the fire of God, the fire of the Holy Spirit. Every false accusation somebody has not spoken, I will be thrown into fire, in the lake of fire, in the mighty name of Jesus. So I dismantle, I dispel, I dismiss any language, in any word, in any frame, begin to yank it with the word of God. I, Remy Kende Taiwo, I will throw that in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord God will honor you in Jesus' mighty name. Begin to pray. Please help me jump. We are going to do a lot of jumping tonight. Please help me jump and to verse 7, the last verse of it. I am for peace, but when they speak, they are for war. Begin to declare that. As for me, as I move around about me, let peace begin to reign. Yekima Kosoto, whosoever is for war, I begin to discharge them out of your life, that you have nothing in me, in the mighty name of Jesus. No violence in my dwelling. Somebody has not spoken, because the Bible says that with peace around my walls, Yekima Kosoto, and prosperity will sit at my gate. According to the word of God, begin to decree that. So hear ye the word of God. According to the word of God, in Psalm 122 verse 7, I decree peace. I declare it around about me, in my environment, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whosoever is for war, we have nothing in me, in the mighty name of Jesus. As you have decreed, so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. I welcome you as you step in, begin to go in, go deeper. I speak, let me tell someone, go deeper. Psalm 121, it is go deeper in Jesus' mighty name. The very second son of the very second psalm of the decree, special one. So I welcome you to this special tent. Those who are ready to see the Lord, begin to step in, begin to move in. Yekemakoso, this particular psalm, help me say, is for is God the help of those who seek Him. That is the theme of it. Is God is the help of those who seek Him. Psalm 121, altogether, it's altogether about 8 verses. Help me say 8 verses. Very short, but you walk through it. He said, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Somebody help me lift Yekimaron. Where will my help come from is a question. Help me say, I will lift up my eyes to the hill. The hill is a place of help. The hills is where you run to. It's not a problem. I will lift up Yekimaron to the hills, Yekimaron. He said, where will it come from? It's a question. Where will that help come from? Begin to look around. But God, Yekimaron, as I look around your divine help, around about, where will the help come from? I speak to someone, verse 2. He said, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Begin to declare that. My help will come from me. Whosoever will help me, you have not spoken. Help me pull it out. We come from the Lord. My divine helper will not be the devil. They will not give you a conditional offer. I'm speaking to someone. They will not give you a condition before they can help you. They will not tie your hands. You will not be in a bondage because you're looking for help. Somebody under the sound of my voice, who will rise up with me? The help that I will get, begin to declare. The help that will come to moi, Remy Kendita, and everyone under the sound of my voice, the kind of help that you will get will be from the Lord. Will be unconditional. Will not be the one that will tie you. Will be a godly help. Help me say. Will be a divine help. Yekima. Will be a timely help. Yekima. In the mighty name of Jesus, it will come speedily. It will be timely. Yeah. It will be godly. It will be holy. Help me say. It will be divine. In the mighty name of Jesus, it will not be a trap. Help me say. The kind of help that I will get, begin to separate. The kind of help, begin to specify someone on that standard. It will not be the one that will put me in bondage. It will not tie me down. It will not tie me to the devil. In the mighty name, it will come from the Lord as you decree. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. And you look around, let me walk through as you're meditating and walking down. Verse 3, it said, he will not allow your foot to be moved. I speak to a warrior. I speak to sons and daughters of Zion. He who keeps you will not slumber. Begin to look around. He will not allow even your foot to dash the stone, according to the book of Psalm 91. He who keeps you will not allow you to your feet to dash the stone, according to verse 11 and 12. If I were you, I would rise up and I will stand. You will not make mistake. You will not you will not walk into error. You will not move into error. Error will not, Yekima. No mistake in the mighty name. Because the one that keeps you, Yekima Koso, will not slumber. He will not sleep, Yekima Koso. He that keeps Israel, Yekima. Behold, I speak to someone. Help me go down, verse 4. We will draw it out. He that keeps Israel, he that keeps Remy Kendita, he that keeps the one warrior, he that keeps the sons and daughters of Zion, will neither sleep nor slumber. Be rest assured, begin to say it, that the Lord is on my case. He will neither sleep or slumber. Begin to decree it and begin to pull it out. Begin to personalize it. I said, behold, just for your information, be aware. Let me announce to you. I declare before the throne of grace. I said, he that keeps Israel, he that keeps Remy Kendita, he that keeps a warrior under the sound of my voice, will not sleep or slumber. In the mighty name of Jesus, he that keeps the sons and daughters of Zion will not slumber. Be confident. That is prayer of confidence. Exuberant declaration of faith. In the mighty name of Jesus, so shall it be in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. Amen. Verse 5 says, the Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade. At your right hand, help me declare that as you're going. The Lord is my keeper. Begin to look around to the left and right in the spirit. The Lord is my keeper. Begin to do. The Lord is your shade. Is my shade. Begin to personalize it. Is your shadow. You came across. You those who abide under the secret place of the Most High, who abide under the shadow of the Most High, they know the secret place. You came across. So is my keeper. Is my rock. Is my refuge. David said several times in Psalm 91, in Psalm 27. Someone under the sound of my voice, who will rise up and wave it as a sword? That here, oh. Yeke, oh heavens, help me declare and walk around and listen, oh heart, Yekima. Walk through every wilderness, every jungle. I say, hear ye the word of God. The Lord is my keeper. Whatever you are going through, you will go. It's your shade. You will not be affected. You will not be injured. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'm speaking to you. You will not lose anything. It's your shade. He will protect you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name. No severe weather will affect you. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name. It's your shade. You will not be taken by the storm of life. You have not prayed. Yeke, somebody understand. Who will underline? Who will pull it out and make it a sword, that even the storm of life, Yekima, will not take me away, because it's my shade, it's my shadow, it's my protector. Begin to pray, and it's my, at my right hand, the place of power, the place of strength, the place of acceptance. That is right hand. Somebody wave it, somebody move it, somebody draw it, somebody pull it. Whatever you're doing, do it with faith, do it by faith. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will honor you as you do so. In Jesus' mighty name. The Bible says, the sun, help me rise up. Verse 6, 121. Help me say 121. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. Begin to declare, begin to personalize it. As for me, moi, yeki makosoto, everyone under the sound of my voice, I speak to warriors, I speak to sons and daughters. I say, as for me, moi, I speak into the heavens. I say, hear, O heavens, yekima, and listen, O earth. The sun will not strike me by day, nor the moon by night. It will not strike that business. It will not strike that ministry. It will not strike your children. Begin to say it. The sun will not strike me by day, nor the moon by night. That is, you will not go down before your time. Your sun will not set in the midday. You will not die untimely death. That is what it means. If you can rise up very well. This sun will not strike me. Begin to say it. I will not be struck by the sun during the daytime, and not the moon by night. Begin to say it. I will not go down before my time. I will not die any untimely death. Yeah, will not be that business will not be brought down. That ministry will not be struck by the day, by the sun, by the day. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to decree and begin to speak. I speak as a warrior. Help me speak. I speak as a mother in Israel. I speak as a shepherdess. I speak as a prophetess. I declare before the throne. I speak as a redeemed child of God. Begin to speak in every capacity. Begin to pull it out as the royal priesthood. Help me decree whosoever you are in Christ. Begin to, I speak as a choir. Whatever you are before the Lord, I speak before the throne of grace. I say, I will not be struck by the sun during the day, nor moon by night. As you say so, I speak to someone. So be it. Let heaven stamp it for you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. The Bible says, verse 7 of Psalm 121. Let me say Psalm 121. Verse 7. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. Begin to say it. Speak to yourself if nobody will speak to you. I say, moi, Remy, Kende Taiwan. I speak to warrior. I say, speak to someone. I say, the Lord will preserve you. So I say to my soul. I say to my children. I say to my life. I speak to everything within me, Yekima. I speak to my lineage. I speak to my children. I speak to my tent. I say, hear ye the word of God. The Lord will preserve us in the around and about, Yekima. He will preserve our soul in the mighty name of Jesus. He will preserve us from every evil. Pull it out, Yekima, and wave it before the throne of grace. Go through the high places and wave it, Yekima. I say, hear, O heavens, Yekima, and listen, O heart. The Lord God, Yekima, will preserve me from every appearances, every shade of evil in the mighty name of Jesus. He will preserve my soul. He will preserve the soul of my household. He will preserve us in Jesus' mighty name. As you decree, someone under the sound of my voice, I say, so be it in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord will honor you in Jesus' name. Help me go down to verse 8. Help me say verse 8 of Psalm 121. Verse 8, the second psalm, the songs of the decree. Help me say the second one. I welcome you to this tent. Verse 8, help me look at it. The Lord shall preserve your going out, Yekime, and your coming in. Somebody has not spoken. From this day henceforth, forevermore. Help me say amen. First key it with amen in the mighty name of, and begin to raise your voice. I say, repeat after. He said, the Lord shall preserve, personalize it. You're going out. Remi Kende Taiwo. I am speaking to a warrior. I say, for you're going out and you're coming in from this time forevermore in Jesus' mighty name. Help me raise your voice in Jesus' name. Begin to raise a voice before the Lord and begin to decree, the Lord shall preserve me from my going in and my coming out in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to decree, he will preserve your children. Begin to speak. I speak in this place. I stand, Yekima, before the throne of grace. I wave it before the Lord. I pull it out. You will preserve us in our going in whenever you are traveling, when you're coming out, wherever you are going, in and out of a country, in and out of a home, in and out, somebody I speak to you, whatever you are going through. I said, you, the Lord will preserve you in your going in and your coming out in the mighty name of, in and out of joy. I said, the Lord will preserve you. I'm speaking to someone under the sound of my voice who can listen to the things of the Spirit, who has that understanding of the Spirit. That I said, the Lord will preserve you in any way, in any, you're going in and you're coming in, you're going out and you're coming in Jesus' name. For it is written, let me say, let me keep it as you come out of this. Isaiah 54. Let me say, Isaiah 54, verse 2. The word of the Lord by the prophet of old, Isaiah 54. Verse 2, he said, Isaiah 54, verse 2. He said, enlarge the place of your tent. Let me say, stretch your tent curtains wide. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords. Strengthen your stake. I speak to someone. In your going in, they begin to say, and my coming out. The Lord will preserve us. He will enlarge us. He will stretch us. He will protect us wherever we go in Jesus' mighty name. Because in Deuteronomy, let me say Deuteronomy 33:18. Deuteronomy 33:18. And as for Zebulun, the blessing of Moses upon the tribe of Zebulun, he said, he you will rejoice, Zebulon, in the going out, and I speak to someone, and Issachar in your tent. So I speak to my children, I speak to my lineage, I speak to my sons, I speak to my daughter. Begin to speak to something, begin to speak to someone under the sound of my tongue. As for me, moi, Remi Kende Taiwo, I speak, I say, here, ho, the daughters of Remi Kende Taiwo, the sons of Remi Kende Taiwo, that I speak to, I say, in your going out, rejoice, O son, in your going out, and my, I say, Issachar, yeah, and my daughters in your tent, begin to say it, begin to personalize it according to the word of God in Deuteronomy, Epistle Deuteronomy 33, verse 18. The blessing of Moses upon the Zebulon, they will rejoice in their going in. So it shall be for each and everyone under the sound of my voice, in the mighty, in Jesus' mighty, mighty name we pray. Amen. Please let me go to 1:22. Help me say 1:22. The third one, as you step in, the joy of going to the house of the Lord. Help me say, begin today. It's the joy of going to the house of the Lord. Please step in and begin to move. 9 verses all together. This one is a Psalm of David. This is a song of ascent. This is a decree in Israel, the ancient Israel. This is compulsory. You must sing this in the house of God. It is a law. 1:22. Help me say it. The songs of the decree. The third one, the 15 all together. Help me look at 1:22, Psalm 1:22. He said, I was glad and I speak to one. Verse 1. Please help me run through it. Help me march through it. Help me write through it. I was glad when they said to me, let's go to the house of the Lord. Somebody begin to declare, I was glad when they said to me, begin today. Happiness when you are going to the house of the Lord. Me, more. I will go with joy. Begin to declare. He said, I was glad when they said unto me, let's go to the house of the Lord. It's a place of joy. It's a place of deliverance. So I speak to my soul. I speak to my body. I speak to my children. I say, you must be happy. You must be glad when you present yourself before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to declare. It's the declaration of your emotions. Be presented before the Lord that whenever I appear more, whenever I appear before the throne of grace, I will appear with gladness. I will appear in joy. I will appear because the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will honor you. Verse 2, help me say verse 2. 1:22. Psalm 1:22, verse 2. It said, our feet have been standing within your gate, O Jerusalem. Somebody occupy heaven. Occupy the gate of heavens. When you are ready, when you are ready to stop, when you are ready to step, when you are ready to shake the gate of heavens, you will pull this one out. You will wave it before the throne. You will wave it before the Lord and say, hey, Yekimakosoto. According to your word, help me begin to decree. It is written, help me say it, in Psalm 1:22, verse 2. Our feet in our house, Yekima, are standing within the gate, are within your gate, O Jerusalem. Within your gate, oh God, let somebody help me stand here and stand very well before the gate of heavens and begin to wave this word before the Lord and begin to shake the gate of heavens and scream out and say, Lord God, as I'm writing through this book of Psalm, my feet are within your gate, oh God, declare it, occupy heaven, occupy the gate of heaven, shake it, move it, Yekima. Make sure you are standing, make sure your spirit is there in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will honor you in Jesus' mighty name. For verse 3, let me say verse 3. Verse 3 says of Psalm 1:22, Jerusalem is built as a city that is compact together, so they are not scattered. Somebody help me pray. You will not be scattered. As I stand before the Lord, everything that is yours, the Bible says Jerusalem is built as a city that is compact. If I were you, I would personalize it. Remi Kende Taiwo, whatever ministry, we are built as a city that is compact together. That ministry is built as a city. PRZ FM radio is built as a city that is compact together. That ministry, that home, that marriage, that business, I speak to someone, whatever you are doing, that project will be compact together. The word compact is important. Begin to decree it will not be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever is built around will be like a city that is all together in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Help me pray. Verse 6, as we jump into verse 6, say, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love you. Help me begin to pray. Pray for the peace of, begin to put your name there. Pray for the peace of your country there, for the peace of Africa, for the peace of Britain, for the peace of wherever you are standing. Pray for the peace of your ministry. For whosoever do so, they say they will prosper, will love thee. Begin to declare, whosoever prays for you will prosper. Whosoever is a prayer, is an advice. Help me begin to say, as you pray, they will prosper in the mighty. Whosoever, Yekima, will pray for me, your business, your ministry. Whosoever is praying, Yekima, I say, they will prosper, Yekima. As you stand, Yekima, for the peace of nation, you must prosper. Help me pray for whichever nation you are standing. I pray for the peace of this land. I'm standing in Great Britain. I'm broadcasting live from London. And I stand in this place and I pray for the city of London. I said, Yekima Kosodro, I pray for the peace of London, Yekima, because the Bible says, those that do so, they will prosper that love thee. So I must prosper in the land, whichever nation you are praying for. That land must yield its increase unto you in the mighty name of. So I speak to Africa. I speak to China. I speak to Hong Kong. I speak to America. I speak with Jera. I speak to Australia. Whichever country is popping to your mind, begin to speak to it. I speak peace into you, because whichever one you are speaking to peace into, you must prosper there. And Britain, I say, here, oh Britain, here, oh England, here, oh London, I must prosper here in the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, say amen. If you believe it, decree it. If you believe it, say so in the mighty name of Jesus. Whichever country you are saying, may the Lord hear you in Jesus' mighty name. May that which you are speaking, I speak to someone, let it be, let may the Lord hear you in the mind. May you speak into the ears of God in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. We pray. Amen. Please help me, as you are coming out, please help me look at verse 7 altogether. I say, peace be within your wall and prosperity within your gate. Begin to declare that it is written, peace will be within your wall. So there is no more violence. Violence must not be heard in your dwelling. Somebody has not spoken, but help me pull it out. No domestic violence. It must not happen in your home in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm speaking. It must not happen in your town. It must not happen in that business. It must not happen in that ministry. It must not happen even within your soul. Your spirit must not be at war. Begin to pray. You must not be confused. Begin to pull it out. Let it become a sword. That it is written, let me say, Psalm 122, verse 7, that there be peace within my walls. Somebody has not spoken. And prosperity within my palaces. Begin to walk around. There will be peace within my tent. Help me create this station as I'm standing broadcasting here. I said there will be peace around there. I speak to my home. I speak to my tent. I speak to ministry. I speak to project. I said there will be peace around. Speak to your marriage. Somebody understand. I speak to you. There will be peace around your world. I speak to someone. I speak to daughters and sons of Zion. I say prosperity. We sit at your palaces. We be within your palaces. You will not lack good things in the mighty name of Jesus. You will have sufficient. Help you say amen. I said sufficiency, divine provision, surplus, abundance. We be with me in the mighty name of Jesus. As you decree, so shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. Amen. I say, and I step out, begin to step out. I quote verse 8, I quote it, and I decree that before the throne of grace. I say, for the sake of my brethren and companions, for the sake of warriors, for the sake of those who constantly turn up and turn in, I say, for the sake of those who can hear me right now, I will now say, I speak to someone, peace be within you. I release the word, begin to reel. I release the word, catch it. I release the word, I release the word, receive it. I say, peace be with you, within you, in Jesus' mighty name. Pull it as a sword. I release that word as I step out, begin to come out, begin to step and begin to move forward, begin to step and begin to step out. Yekima Kosodo, that God, I say, for the sake of brethren, I repeat, Yekima, and for the sake of companion, I say to so the companions, I said, I will now say to everyone who can hear me, I say, let the peace, let it be within you in Jesus' mighty name. Receive the peace, inner peace in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Help me step in, begin to come. Psalm 123. Help me say Psalm 123, the Psalm of David, the title, the prayer for relief from contempt, from contempt, which means reproach. Yekimakoso, I'm speaking to someone. 4 verses altogether. We will not stay long. The Song of Ascent. Help me say 1, 2, 3. Begin to declare. He said, "Unto you," verse 1. "Unto you I lift my eyes, O God, who dwells in the heaven." Help me walk around people who have occupied the gate of the heavens, people who have been standing by in Psalm 122, people who have walked through 122. We say boldly 1, 2, 3. Help me say 1, 2, 3 boldly, that I will lift up you. "Unto you," help me, dear, "not anyone else. I lift up my eyes, O Lord, you that dwells in heaven," not anywhere. "You that lives in the heavens of heavens," begin to pray that I look up to you. "You that lives," Yekimakosoro, very specific, very direct, very, begin to say, "You, not anybody. You that lives direct, that lives in the heaven." May the Lord hear you as you say so. Because verse 2 says, help me say verse 2 of 1 to 3. He said, "Behold," and I say to someone, "Be aware," I say, "listen." I say, let someone listen to this. He said, said, as the eyes of the servant look to the hands of his master, as the eyes of a maid look to the hands of her mistress, so my eyes, Yekima, so our eyes, Yekima, look to the Lord in our home, in our country, in our begin to say, in your ministry, this place, in our tent, this generation, our eyes, Yekima, they look up to the Lord, our God, until he has mercy upon us. Occupy London, occupy the gate of heavens, occupy it, Yekimakos, for those who are ready to go. I'm speaking to occupier, people who are ready to go occupy the gate, who are ready to see the Lord, who will continue to bang and bang until something comes out of it, in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, until he has mercy on us, may you seek the Lord as you step in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 3, help me say verse 3 of Psalm 1, 2, 3. He said, have mercy on us. He said, have, O Lord, have mercy on us twice, for we are exceedingly filled with contempt, with reproach. He said, have mercy upon us. I now come, begin to say it. I now speak to everyone. He said, have mercy upon us. Everyone that is going through every reproach, begin to shred them and say before the Lord, have mercy, I occupy the gate of heavens. Have mercy, my feet are standing within your gate. Have mercy, I'm speaking, O God. Have mercy, because unto you I look up to, you that dwell in the heavens. May the Lord have mercy upon you in Jesus' mighty name. For verse 4, let me say verse 4. Our soul is exceedingly filled with scorns of those who are at ease, with contempt of the proud. So we stand before the throne of grace and begin to report every reproach before the Lord. That God, I have come to occupy the gate of heavens as I pass through, begin to pass through in the mighty name of Jesus. Report every reproach before the Lord. Every form that you have heard, that you can hear in your spirit, begin to speak out. That God, begin to scream every reproach. Begin to mention them before the throne of grace, that our soul is exceedingly filled with that scorns. I stand before you and I report this in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not be ridiculed, you will not be ashamed in the mighty name of Jesus. May you be heard in the mighty name of Jesus. For the book of the Lord, the word of God in Numbers, let me say Numbers chapter 14 verse 28, it said, that which you have spoken I speak to a warrior, that which you have said I speak to daughters of Zion. He said, that I will do, that I will do in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord do great thing in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Help me step in into Psalm 124. Someone know that the sound of my voice tonight. Psalm 124, the Psalm of David, the song of decree, the second one of the decree that David wrote, among the compulsory one, the 15 altogether to be sung in the house of the Lord. Help me say, the Lord, the defense of this people. That's the theme of this one. The song of ascent is of David. Help me say, it's of David. He wrote 4 altogether. This is the second one. Begin to, the 8 verses, I begin to pronounce, begin to proclaim, begin to announce and shout, because this is the Lord, the defense of the people, the defender of the people, the defender of the fatherless. I'm talking to you. And of the widow, that is the one you are walking through the tent. Begin to walk through this tent, because Psalm 68 verse 4 says, a father to the fatherless, a defender of the widow, is God in his holy dwelling. I speak to someone that who we cry out to the Lord and they are ready to see the Lord. Please help me look at verse 1. Let me say verse 1. Psalm 124 verse 1. The Lord will honor you. Help me look at it and look at it critically. He said, if it had not been, help me look around. The Lord who was on our side, Yekimakosol, let Israel now say, please begin to personalize that, to walk through. I said, if it had not been, begin to meditate. The contemplation, the thinking, the reflection, the meditation of someone under the sound of my voice. I said, verse 1, I said, if it had not been, help me look around. The Lord who was on our side, as I stand before the throne of grace, and I stand before the saints, and I stand before you warriors, came across. I said, if it had not been, the Lord who was on our side, somebody help me. Let Remy now say, let Israel now say, let London now say, let a warrior now say, he came across, be he repeat it in verse 2. He said, if I had not been the Lord who was on our side, help me say it for the second time. He came out, beat your chest and walk up and down. When men rose up against us, he came across, when challenges, he came, I begin to say, rose up, he came across, when storm started, somebody brought the sound of man, when the raging wall started, he came across, when the raging storm started, he came, when there was tempest, he came out, when it was tempest, when there was tempest, oh God, if he had not been for God, when men rose against us, epic decree, begin to say it, begin to walk as you are meditating over this. Then I said, speak to someone, verse 3. Then they would have swallowed us up. We are looking at Psalm 1 to 4. Then they would have swallowed us, verse 3, us alive, when their wrath was kindled against us, but you did not allow it. They would have swallowed us up. The land would have opened us up. They would have taken us down. You could have gone into bankruptcy. They could have messed your life up. They could have messed you up. You could have lost everything. I'm speaking to someone. When their wrath was kindled against us, help me look at as you are meditating, the contemplation, the thinking, the meditation. Verse 4, help me say verse 4. Then the water would have overwhelmed us. But it didn't happen. It would have, Yekema, the stream would have gone over our soul. You did not allow it. Yekema, Kosotor, because this a psalm of David is coming through. The psalm of David, a song and a psalm. Psalm 66, I would say 66, verse 12. It says, you caused men to ride over our head. We went through fire, I'm speaking to someone, and through water. But you brought us to a worthy place, to a place of fulfillment, Yekema, to a place of satisfaction. Help me wave this before the Lord. Wave it before the Lord. Wave it as a banner that God is a psalm and a song, the psalm of David. I borrow it, pull it, stretch it before the throne of grace. I say Psalm 66 verse 12, when you caused men to ride over us, but you brought us to a worthy place as we walk through the psalm in Jesus mighty name. Verse 5, episode 5 of 1 to 4, then the swollen water will have gone over our soul. Let me say that, blessed be the Lord who has not given us as a prey to their teeth. Verse 6, our soul has escaped. That is where I'm going. Let me stand here. We have escaped. Let me say it, Yekima. My begins to say it. My soul has escaped, Yekima. Our soul has escaped, Yekima, as a bird from the snares of the fowler, Yekima. The snare is broken. Let me declare that. We have escaped. Let me declare that in the mighty name of Jesus. I said, our soul has escaped. That ministry begins to say it. You have escaped. The business, you have escaped from the birds as a bird, Yekima, from the snares of the fowler. Whatever needs to escape, begin to say it in the mighty name. That addiction must escape as a bird from the snares of fowler in the mighty name of Jesus. The snare is broken. Let me say it. The snare over your life is broken. I speak to someone. We have escaped in Jesus' mighty name. As you decree it, so be it in the mighty name of Jesus. For the song of David is coming through. The psalm of David is the contemplation of David. Another one in Psalm 32. Help me borrow it. Help me knock on the tent. 32 verse 7. It says, you are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with a song of deliverance. Somebody help me begin to lift this before the Lord. That you are my hiding place. You deliver us. Begin to say, we have escaped. May you escape in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree before the throne of grace, according to verse 8, that our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord will honor you. Let's run quickly. Help me step into Psalm 1 to 5. Someone under the sound of my voice, we will step into 1 to 5 with me in Jesus' mighty name. 5 verses all together. As you decree, begin to go. Verse 21, 1 to 5. The songs of ascent, the unknown writer. As you step into this tent, as you walk 15 psalms altogether, we're going to cover just 17 in this series. Help me look at it. 1 to 5. Those who trust in the Lord, help me decree, are like Mount Zion, begin to, which cannot be moved, but abide forever. They are unshakable. They came across, so begin to say it. Those that trust in the Lord, we trust in the Lord, we are like Mount Zion. Declare it today. In our house, we are like Mount Zion. This business is like Mount Zion. This ministry is like Mount Zion. My life is like Mount Zion. Begin to say, that cannot be moved. They came across, that abides forever. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to decree. Someone understand. May the Lord hear you. Pull it out as a sword. Wave it before the Lord. We trust in the Lord. We are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved. He said, those that trust, and I'm one of those that trust in the Lord without wavering, in the waving, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says verse 2. Let me say verse 2 of 1 to 5. Somebody will walk around. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, begin to decree it. Don't do so. Begin to walk around. I say, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surround his people from this time forth and forever. Begin to decree that around your dwelling right now. Somebody on that stand, you will walk around in your spirit. You will see it with the eyes of the spirit. We say, as the mountains surround Jerusalem, I speak concerning my home. So the Lord will surround me. He will surround these people with fire in the mighty name of Jesus. From this time now, and forever seal it. And forever seal it, someone, in the mighty name of that settles it. I speak to someone. Verse 2 of 1 to 5. Psalm 1 to 5. The Lord surround his people from now on forth and forever in the mighty. He will surround you with fire in the mighty. He will surround you with his angels. He will surround you with the host of heaven. He will surround you with the armies of heavens in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. This is verse 3. I want us to quickly go. For the scepter, help me say, help me wave this. Help me pull it out. Stretch it, pull it, draw it, but make sure you underline it and pull it and drag it out. That for this, the scepter of the wicked shall not rest upon the land allotted to the righteous, lest the righteous reach out their hands to iniquities. Begin to speak, begin to say, the scepter of the wickedness shall not rest on the land of the Lord. The wicked, the act of the wicked people must not affect you, must not be affected. God forbid. That was the word of Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 3 verse 4. I said, God forbid, may it not be in the mighty name of Jesus. Help me rise and rise very well. The scepter and the authority, the curse of the wicked cannot rest on the allotment of the land allotted to the righteous in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it not be heard. Let it not be said in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Help me pull it out. The scepter of the wickedness cannot rest. Shall not rest, must not rest. Every language, begin to decree it. Make a mark on the land allotted to Moab, to the righteous, to Remiken the Tayo, to a warrior, to a son or daughter of Zion. It must not. God forbid. Help me say it according to the word of God in Romans 3 verse 4. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Help me write through verse 4. Help me say verse 4. Psalm 1 to 5. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, and to those who are upright in your heart. Please help me do good, oh Lord. What? To those who are good, not those who are bad. Because the Bible says, Isaiah 3:10, it says, say to the righteous, it is well with them. So I speak to myself, I speak to a warrior, I speak to sons and daughters of Zion, I speak to the people in the place of prayer. I say, it is well. It says, say to good people, I speak to good people of God, I say, it is well. To those who are upright, say to those who are good, who are upright, and say, do good, O Lord, to those. I pray and I decree that the Lord will do good to everyone on the sound of my voice. Who is riding through tonight? Who is riding through in Jesus' mighty name? In Jesus' mighty name. Begin to come out of 125 as you look at verse 5. Somebody on the sound of my voice, who will look at? He said, as you turn, as for such as turn aside to the crooked wood, the Lord shall lead them away with the workers of iniquities. Begin to come out and say, as for me, I will not go. The ways of the righteous, the Bible says, they are ordered by God. According to Psalm 37, verse 23, let me say, they are ordered in the mighty name of Jesus. Another psalm, the word of the psalm, the word of God, which I will draw tonight, he say, as for the Lord, Psalm 18 verse 30, his way is perfect. So I come out, no crooked way we come. I will walk the straight path in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will order my step, he will order your step, he will order the step of everyone who will say amen at this moment and key into it in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord God will honor you in Jesus' mighty name. And we all say amen. And it says, peace be upon Israel as you come out. Personalized as you come out. I say, peace be upon a warrior. Peace be upon Remy Kende Taiwa. Peace be upon PRZ FM 109.2. Peace be upon a listener listening, somebody listening to me right now. May the peace of God rest upon you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' mighty name. We are riding through and we're going to jump very fast in this one. Psalm 126. Help me say 126. The joyful return to Zion. This is important. Please position yourself. Please be ready. The joyful return to Zion. Someone under the sound of my voice. The song of ascent. This one, surprisingly, this particular one is about the deliverance of the people of God out of bondage and distress. That this psalm was penned at the time, and most likely more like the return out of Babylon during the time of Ezra. But this particular psalm, I'm looking at, probably might be penned by Ezra, the scribes, Jekima. So some of the prophets that came up they came up first with it. And even the children of Asaph, Epi said the children of Asaph, the famous psalmist I'm talking, also returned with them. The Bible said the children of Asaph returned with them when they came back from captivity, when this was put together in Ezra. Help him write it down, help him pen it down. Yes, someone do not do suffer, help him pull it out your pen in Ezra chapter 2 verse 41. Ezra chapter 2 verse 41, the Bible says the singers and the children of Asaph, the children of Asaph which we have looked, they wrote Psalm 50 and 73 right up to 83. The children of Asaph, the Psalm of Asaph, those children, those singers, those Levites, they came back from this lineage, the Asaphites, they came back as 128. That was what the Bible said. They are the time when this was penned. So help me read it. So when you read it with understanding that they came back from the Babylon captivity, and it was recorded. It was penned around that time. The songs of Ascend. Help me say the songs of Ascend. Psalm 126. Help me look at it. When the Lord brought back. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, began to, we were like those who dream. Help me decree that and walk around. I say when, which means there is a time. At a time, there is a particular time. It's a matter of time. I'm speaking to someone. When the Lord is a subordinate clause, is a conjunction. Anyhow, he said when there is a time, there is a when, there is a allocated time. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we are like those who dream. To begin to declare it, the captivity, the release of Israel, the release of someone under the sound of my voice, the turning around. They turn again for the second time. He said, "Yeah, came out." They were returning. He said, "When he brought it back again, we are like them. Those who dream dreams begin to. We are like them, like those who watch film. Yeah, came out. We were like them because we couldn't believe it. Yeah, came out. It was as if we are watching film every." We begin to pray and begin to come out as you are coming, as you are decreeing, though God, we are like them. What you will do in my life, you have not raised a prayer before the Lord. Let it be like a dream. You came across. Do things that will be like a dream. We will be like them who watch him. We will be like them who dream dreams. Whatever you are saying, you came across, begin to decree before the Lord. Let it be in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible said, verse 2, let me say verse 2. Of Psalm 126, someone on that sound of my voice, verse 2 of 126. It said, then our mouth was filled with laughter. Help me say that. Our mouth was filled with laughter. Our tongue with singing. They said among the nation, they said it, we didn't say it. They said it, they can say it. They, because things came out. He said, they said among the nation, the Lord has done great things for them. Begin to walk through this. Our mouth will be filled with laughter. He said, it was filled with laughter. We were happy, begin to say, joy will not depart from our tent. Verse 2, begin to pull it out. Our mouth was filled with laughter. We will be filled with laughter. Our tongue, came out. So the mouth is filled with, the mouth is for laughter, but tongue is for singing. I'm speaking to someone, the deep things of the spirit. He said, then they said among them, they said it, they realized it, they noticed the good, great thing that the Lord was doing, and they decreed. It was the people that said the Lord has done great things for us. We didn't tell them. Begin to say it. Let things begin to speak in my life. Somebody has not spoken. I said, let your tongue begin to sing. Yeah. Let my mouth begin to laugh. There are two things happening. Let them begin to happen. Let things begin to happen in my life that will make people to say the Lord has done great things. Let that be result. Begin to say it in the mighty name of Jesus. Things must happen in your tent. Let things must happen in your life that will make people to declare. It was the people that said the Lord has done great things in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you and I'm to the presence of God. Help me look at verse 3 of 126 as we are running through. The Lord has done great things for us and we are glad. Begin to declare. Personalize it. Note it. There are great things, not small things. Please help me decree this. The Lord has done great things, not small things for us, and we are glad. Begin to walk up and down your tent. The great impossible things, the Lord has done great things, the unbelievable things for us, and we are glad. I decree that, pull it out, Yekim, and wave it before the Lord, that you will do great things, not small things, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord hear you as you say to in Jesus' mighty name. For the Bible says, those that sow in tears, they shall reap in joy. I decree that in verse 5 as you jump in the mighty name of Jesus, because the Bible says, everyone that went to Jesus, they returned, they were glad. They came across in the mighty name of Jesus, according to Luke 8, verse 40. So you will come back. Let me say, I have been to the presence of God. I'm walking through the tent. I will come back. I will reap joy in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Please begin to come out and come with me as you stand with me as we look at the very last one. Help say very last one. Maybe you haven't been talking, but don't miss this very last one. Speak with all your heart, speak with all your soul in the mighty name of Jesus as you come out. I welcome you to the last tent, the Psalm 127. Let me say 127. The Song of Ascent. This one was written by Solomon. Let me say Solomon. The Psalm of Solomon, the Song of Ascent, compulsory in Israel, to be in the archives, a decree in the land. Help me look at it. 127, the one of the seven, altogether 15, from 120 to from Psalm 120 to 134. Please help me look at 127. It's about laboring and prospering with the Lord. The Ascent, the Song, the Song of Ascent, the Psalm of Solomon. Altogether, Solomon wrote just two. He wrote 127, help me say 127, Psalm 127, and Psalm 72. Psalm 72. Please help me look around as he was building the house of the Lord. He wrote one, he penned it, he reflected. You will see, when you look at the writing, it's just like the book of Ecclesiastes, the preacher. Help me, like the book of the Proverbs. Help me look at it. 127, Psalm 127, as we walk through it tonight in the presence, in the mighty name of Jesus. He says, and I speak to someone, who will say it out? Unless the Lord build the house, they labor in vain who build it. Begin to decree. Unless the Lord build our home, unless the Lord build our marriage, unless the Lord step in, you are asking for God to step in. Unless you are here, somebody has not spoken. Unless you can step into my work, unless you can step into that marriage, unless you can step into our ministry, unless you can step into our lives, God, Jacobin, whosoever labor, they just do it in vain. We need God's presence. That is what it means. I need God to complete this. Whosoever wants to complete a project, we ask tonight as I stand before the throne of grace, we say, hear, O heavens, and listen, O earth, unless you build it, O God, unless you step in, O God, those that do it, they just do in vain. You will pray this prayer, and the Lord will hear you in Jesus' mighty name. Unless you guide the city, the watchman stays awake. Begin to decree divine protection, because it will build an edge of tongue around you. His favor is like a shield. That's what the Bible says in Psalm 5, verse 12. So, God, unless the Lord guide the city, unless the Lord protect that house, unless the Lord guide that marriage, unless the Lord guide your children, is I said the watchman, the parents, whosoever is staying awake, the wife, the mother, the husband, whosoever is staying awake, they just stay in vain. Unless God answers, step in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone, we jump into verse 3 and stand before and say, behold, verse 3 of Psalm 127. He said, behold, and I speak to a warrior, behold, I speak to a mother. The real I speak to mothers in Israel. I said, behold, children are heritage from the Lord. The fruit of the womb is a reward. Just in case, probably you are not aware, who will stand up with me? Their heritage, their inheritance, they are part of your inheritance. You must get it. Somebody under the sand of man, who will rise up with me and say, they are fruit of the womb. We will decree the word of God that none of us will be barren in the land. That was the blessing of God upon the Israelites. So you say, behold, they are in heritage of the Lord. May you receive it in Jesus' name. Begin to claim, begin to come out, begin to shake your head, begin to say, like a arrow is in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Begin to say it, like an arrow in the hand of a warrior. They will be my pride. They will only begin to say, pray for them to be bold and brave, they to be swift like warrior. I said, like a arrow is in the hands of a warrior. They will make me confident. They will speak in the right places. They will begin to say, in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not be double-hearted, in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to someone, I speak to a father in Israel, I speak to a warrior, I speak to everyone under the sound of my voice. Verse 5, let me say, happy is the man, begin to walk around. Your children must not bring sadness. Say, happy is the man who has his cover full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they will speak to the enemies at the gate. So the Bible says, happy are we, okay? Happy are you, biological, spiritual children, begin to stand up. He said, happy are we. Begin to declare happiness. You must have happiness over them. Someone under the sound of my voice, you must have happiness, because they will not be ashamed. That is what the Bible says. They will not bring shame to you. They will not walk the walk of shame. They will not be clothed in shame, in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak as a mother. I speak as a mother in Israel. Begin to speak, somebody. I speak as a shepherdess. I speak as a prophetess. I stand in this place and I say, Yekimakolo, that it is written. Begin to say, happy is the man who has his quiver. Happy is the woman who has them full of them. They will not be ashamed. Remy Kendeta, I will not be ashamed. I'm speaking to a warrior. You must not be ashamed. I speak to daughters and so on. You will not be ashamed, in the mighty name of Jesus. You shall speak to the enemies at the gate. I speak to everyone trusting the Lord for the fruit of the womb. The Lord will give it to you in Jesus, in this season, in this dispensation, in the mighty name of Jesus. Because I remember the Genesis 24:60, the prayer of Laban upon Rebekah. And the Bible says, and they blessed Rebekah and said unto her, thou art our sister, be thou mother of thousands of millions. Let thy seed possess the gate of those who hate them. So I pray there, I release that prayer unto everyone who is still trusting, who are about to put to bed. I said, your seed, I speak to you. You will be mothers of millions, thousands, in the mighty name of Jesus. Your seed will possess the gate of those who hate them, in the mighty name of Jesus. May you receive that in the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. According to the blessing that the Lord placed upon Abraham after testing him with Isaac, the Bible says it was recorded in Genesis, episode Genesis 22 verse 17. You will not miss this. Genesis 22 verse 17. And the Lord said after the test that I will surely bless you and make your descendant, your seed, as numerous as stars in the skies, as sand on the seashore. Your descendant, I speak to someone, they will take possession of the city of their enemy. So help me stand here in the mighty name of. They will speak at the gate. Begin to speak, begin to release the blessing over you as you come out of this tent, as you stand with me before the Lord, as you stand before the gate of heavens, as you shake it, as you occupy the gate of heavens, as you are walking through the tent, the sons of ascent, let me rise up that your seed, your God, I speak to my lineage, I speak to my lineage, I speak to my seed, I stand for my generation, I say, hear ye the word of God, you will make me happy, begin to say it. You will speak to enemies at the gate, you will not be ashamed, you will not be clothed in shame, you will, the spirit of shame will not enter into you, in the mighty name, you will not be disgraced, you will not be naked, you will not be stripped, you will not fall, in the mighty name of Jesus. I walk around my tent, I declare over my, begin to declare something, in the mighty name of Jesus. Dear, oh, you daughters of, you sons of, begin to mention your, you will not be put to shame, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will speak to the enemies at the gate, you will make me proud, in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not build in vain, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will build my home, he will build my life, he will build my marriage, he will build my project, he will build this ministry, he will build, begin to decree. Someone on that stand of, who is praying, who is charging, who will make their way out and stand before the Lord in this period, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will honor you. I welcome you once again. This is Remy Kende Taiwo, a special prayer conference before the Lord throne of grace, and we have been trashing through the tent of the psalmist. I thank everyone that keeps returning. I speak to every warriors, every sons and daughters of Zion that keeps returning. I say you will not be tired. The Lord will uphold you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we will trash through and we get to the last page in the mighty name of Jesus. The book of Psalms, the work of the psalmist, the prayer of the psalmist. I welcome you to the presence of God as you continue to pray before the throne of grace. I say, God, you, the Lord God, we do great thing in this time, in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. He will make his face to shine on you. You will not be tired, you will not be weary, in the mighty name of, he will strengthen you in Jesus' mighty name. Continue to rise before the throne of grace. I say, continue to rise before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not fail, you will not falter, in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to everyone under the sound of my voice. I say, it shall be well with you. The Lord will strengthen you. You will see the Lord in this season, oh God. I speak to someone, I say, according to the word of God, the Lord God, this God, Yekimakoso, we visit you in the mighty name of Jesus. May you have a visitation from the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. I say, may the Lord visit you in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not be put to shame, in the mighty name of Jesus. You begin to, I say, you will not be put to, as you rise up with me and sing before the Lord in the mighty name of Jesus, in this period, in this season, in Jesus' mighty, mighty name. Amen. Once again, it's Remy Kende Taiwo signing off. Good morning, Britain. Presence.